I'm delighted to be here in St. Bridget's Cathedral today to wish you all a very happy Christmas in these very strange times. This morning, a little red-breasted robin hopped up to my kitchen window, and I was reminded of how the appearance of the robin signifies that Christmas is about to happen. When I see a robin, I think Christmas. The robin is a sign pointing to something that's coming. Advent in the church calendar is the same thing, except that Advent points to someone, not something. In the weeks of Advent, we look forward to remembering and celebrating the birth of the most important child to be born ever, because his coming signals the rescue plan for the whole world. This Christmas, there are signs of hope. It might be a dark, isolating place for some, and we cannot minimize the sadness and loneliness this Christmas that it will be for some of these folk. There are those who will have been bereaved this year, including myself, who will be missing someone around the Christmas table and who inevitably will feel sad. There'll be a particular grief over those who've been lost to COVID, a pain that both isolates but brings us together in solidarity. There will be utterly exhausted medical staff who will have been pushed to the limit all year and are in desperate need of rest. There will be members of our government who are hoping and praying that they are making the best decisions for our welfare and desperately hope that we will continue to comply. But there is hope on the horizon. Whilst we are nervous of the new variants of the virus, and we do have to be extra careful for the next few months, the vaccine is within our reach. We've been hoping and praying for this all year, and at last it will be rolled out, first to the most vulnerable, and then hopefully to us all. This time next year, with God's help and the wisdom of science, we will be in a very different place, and we will appreciate it all the more. I know that some of you will miss loved ones this year who've not been able to travel, and that is lonesome. My own son is in lockdown in Vancouver, and he will miss us as much as we will miss him. We are all in this together. Nobody has escaped 2020 without a scratch. We have come this far, and we mustn't turn back. As the robin signifies that Christmas is very nearly here, our signs of hope signify that we're at the tail end of a horrendous, painful year. We have all suffered fear, anxiety, isolation, and loneliness, but it is almost over. I hope and pray that you will feel, despite the daily news and numbers that can overwhelm and depress us, that hope is just around the corner, and that the light of Christ continues to sustain us. If we know that someone journeys alongside us, we can bear most things. He is with us, the Lord Jesus, Emmanuel. I wish you a very happy and safe Christmas. Branches of it looking at me.
It's been a very difficult year. The past 10 months has shattered most of us. I think particularly of the bereaved, those who have lost loved ones through COVID or buried loved ones during the period of this pandemic. Your Christmas will be very different. There will be empty chairs around a lot of homes this Christmas. I think of those working on the front line, our nurses, our doctors, our porters, our priests, our religious, our volunteer sanitizers, our stewards, our shopkeepers, our postmen, our postwomen, our guards, our local authority officials, our organizations, and our outreach groups, our schools, our social clubs, our sports clubs, our local media, our local radio, our local newspapers. You see, we are all on the front line, and we've been on that front line for the past 10 months. Christmas reminds us that God is always on our front line. We are never alone. Other things may disappear. The glamour of that tinsel gift at Christmas will wear off, but God remains with us forever. I think of the little boy I met in junior infants a couple of years back, visiting his school, and I invited the children to tell me what Christmas was all about, what we were celebrating at Christmas. I got a huge range of answers until one little girl shouted, "Baby Jesus is born." To which the young boy immediately replied, "Not at all, he was born last year." These are the days, Christmas Eve particularly, where we're assembling our crib. The manger is empty, but it's set up. The ox and donkey are there, and maybe a shepherd keeping an eye on the animals. Today, Christmas Eve, Mary and Joseph arrive and prepare the manger for the birth of baby Jesus, the one wrapped in swaddling clothes. When the song of the angel is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and the Orient princes have left and the shepherds are back with their flocks, it is only then that the work of Christmas begins. May each of us this coming year, may we find the lost. May we heal the broken, and may we feed the hungry. This Christmas, each of us are that innkeeper who decides if there's room in here to welcome Jesus. I encourage you to make room for Jesus this Christmas. For many who may not feel comfortable at attending masses or religious services, remember, your kitchen table is an extension of the altar. Whether it's the altar in your parish church or the altar in this splendid St. Brigid's Cathedral in Kildare, your home is your little church this Christmas and has been your little church for the past 10 months. My prayer at Christmas is that the Lord may truly make us grateful for one another, maybe like never before. And as we look at those empty chairs, let us take solace and comfort for knowing that they are now with God and He never leaves us. every blessing for Christmas and the new year 2021.
To be.